unpacked. After you're fully satisfied and you think it's good, you pack it. When you pack it, it becomes a real extension of the CRX file, which is just a zip file. It's nothing new. A zip file with all the folder that what you mentioned. And then you submit that on the web store, as we mentioned. You have to verify yourself, pay $5 once in a lifetime, you whatever, and you submit that in your name, and it becomes available. One thing I didn't mention in the previous thing is the updates of the extension. We know that the manifest has a version number. So if you increase the version number and you publish the new version, Chrome will automatically update the user with the new extension, automatically. So it's like Chrome itself. When you have Chrome, it's online, it says, I have a new version, can I please restart or launch the new version? The extensions, it's automatically updated. Chrome manages that. The web store knows you have version 1, it is on now 1.2. As a user, it will push 1.2 automatically to you. If you want the store to handle your sales. If you handle it yourself, you can do it. Also, it's also available, but as you like. Was there a question? Yes.
Is there any number of extensions that a developer can upload? No.
It's like as much as you want, yes.
My back of the extension, is the code that's encrypted? Or anybody can just back it and see that?
That's a good question. I don't have the answer to that. Let me look it up, and you can meet me in the demo ports. I'll get you the answer. Oh, please do.
Yeah. Can't do it directly, but you can pay a safety extension on the file system, and there you can see the source code.
So, because you have it locally?
Yeah.
You have it locally.
Then you just have to print it, and then you can see the source code.
But it's an HTML page, right? The user gets the source of the HTML. Right? Okay, guys? Should we move to another slightly more complex example? So the second example is context menu sample. This text exactly is what's on the web page. So I find it here. Okay, context menu sample. So this sample just creates a context menu. A context menu is when the user right click on the mouse, so a drop down menu appears. This is called a context menu. We didn't mention that in the many UIs that we mentioned. We said we have page action, we have browser action, there's so many others. One of those many others is context menu. So basically, let me, I have a source here. Let's go and try it. Rules, extensions, load unpacked. Context menu, and I give it just a folder. And I say yes. So now we have it, it's enabled. I go to any page and the context menu. It says here, it adds these two menus to the same. So these two lines are the extension. These two lines are the extension. Everything else is already there. Because there's only one context menu for a click, right? You cannot have your own context menu. Just add items to it. Okay, is the extension here? It just creates a menu. I'll open now the source so that we can look at it. Any questions so far?
No.
Okay. So let's look at our source. Background, sample, manifest. Like this. So this is the manifest, minimum manifest, as you can see. Name, description, version, permissions, and what's the background page. This is like a minimum manifest. You notice that it doesn't say page action or whatever, so it's not what it is. Just a background, something that sits in the background. And this is the background page. It just says load this JavaScript, basically. And let's look at the JavaScript. Looks a bit large, So, but it's really not. This is the part that we care about most. Chrome, the context menus, would create. So you create a context menu and call it test parent item. And you call that parent. And then you add child one, child two to this parent item. So this is creating a menu with two sub-menus. Okay? On click, you show things and you do things. We will not go into the details of this, just for debugging. It doesn't do anything to you. If you click here, this is child one. It just says, prints a debug of what you print. What you have. Of course, this is the data that you have when you hit the click. You can process it to do real work. This is for explanation purposes. All kinds of click, here another one, create the parent type. And you have to give it the function, which is the callback when it's gone, when it's called. As you mentioned, all API calls are callbacks, or use callbacks. Our brothers who are trying, are you able to see this menu? If you right click, you see those things?
Are you seeing these all the tabs?
Yes. You can try to decide if you want to add it or not, but in general, it's a context menu.
Can I pull up some information from the page itself?
You can only do that using content script.
Content script.
Remember, we mentioned something. We said it's a bit restricted, and it works on the contents of the page that the user sees. So you can do that using. You can have a content. Our next example is a bit complex, and it has a content script. So the extension itself usually doesn't have access to the data that the user is seeing. Except if it's a content script. Like, extension is a program, right? It shows you its menu and its pages. So everything is from the extension. Extension, so you know what you should. To access what the user is seeing, this is very critical and not easy. So it's happened through the context script, content script, which is a script that runs on the content of the user page, not the extension page. Our next example and last one is a bit more complex and it has one of those. So we will look at it. Who here writes code? Any form of code? Okay, so as you know, showing code is not really the best way to teach coding. So excuse this weak format, but really to learn this, you have to play with it. We agree on that, right? So I'm showing you where is the menus, how things look like, how the source looks like. But my expectation is that hopefully you go home and play with it and make yourself a Hello World extension. And then you can dig deeper in the details. Okay, I'm going to move on to the last example for today. Do you have any questions so far? Okay. So let me remove this one. Email this page. So this page is the page that the user is looking at. And if the user has a selection, it will put a selection in the email also. So it will know the URL of the page to email it. And optionally will put the selection that the user has. So this starting to be a real useful extension.
But has that extension كيف تطلع مثلا انا عندي صفحه وفيها منيو ولا كيف اطلع القوه على الصفحه نفسها؟
ما حنشوف دلوقتي في الاكزامبل اهو جاي انتظر عليا تمام؟ This has the background page and the content script. As I mentioned, the content script has access to what the user is seeing. So for content script to work, it can only work through messages. It has to do a very specified call with the data that it wants to share, which is copied from or extracted from the user page. So it puts that as a message and sends a message, and the background page will have a listener of this event, and it will process this data. So there is no call, there is no code, only message. I'm sending you, I'm saying, I want you to look at this data. So it's data. And the listener is code, it reads the data and starts processing it. So this is the line of the extension. And this is the icon, and this is the details. I have downloaded the source already. So I'll just go here and say load unpacked. Email this page by Google. If you search for email this page by Google, you'll find it in our page. I'll go really slow to allow our developing brothers to get time to get to it. Okay. Load unpacked. Find the temp folder. Okay. So it's loaded. You see here the icon and the title is email this page. I click on it. It will open a new tab. Actually, it's changing the current page and it put the URL for this page. If I have a selection, say this is my selection, and I click on it, put the URL and the selection text. Okay, so this is how it works. Let's look at the code. You will notice now the functionality is almost real, so you'll see that the code is not trivial. So we'll not go into every line of code because explaining code by presentation is not really that useful, but we know what is what and we see how it works. Yes?
Subject is taken from page title?
We'll look at the code. I don't even remember. Let's see. Yes, I guess it's the page title. We'll see the code that composes this page. So probably it have what you just saw. Yes. So this is the manifest, name, description, version, background page. So we have a background page. We have options page. And we have permissions, whatever. And we say that this is a browser action, and this is the title and the icon. Okay? So we should be very familiar now with this manifest. Options page, you click right click on it, it shows you the options. So this is a reserved one, options page. And you put any page there, but it has to be under the code options page. This is the option page, I'll not go through it, but what we care about is here, it's looking at this feature of HTML5, the local storage. So it stores your options locally on your machine, on the user's machine, using the window.local storage option. And the options are really simple or trivial. Let's see them. Just use the mail or specifically Gmail. So the option is either something or null. Null means use the default. Something which is Gmail, it hard codes the word Gmail somehow. So this is the only option you have, or the only choice of options. One variable with two possible values. Okay? Yeah, this is HTML5. There is another presentation of HTML5. I hope it's today. So this feature stores the data locally on the user. It's like cookie, but cookie replaced it because cookie is so messy. This is a bit structured, and it's inside the user. So you don't have the data on the server at all. There's no data on the server. So we're looking at the options we have here. It stores whatever, the same, all the details we will not go through, except that this is like page with two inputs, two radios, and store the data. This is the most critical line of here, of the options. If you select Gmail, you put the word Gmail, otherwise you put none, or empty string. This is your options, and this is what we care about on all this page. The details are just technical. You can review it as you wish. The context script is very small and very minor. It creates data, and it creates a message with this data and sends it to the background page. So the context script didn't work yet. We just know that it takes data and sends it. And the data is the title to be used as the subject for the email, and the selection, if any. So this is almost required, it will always be full because there's always a title. And the selection, if the user has a selection, it will be there. If he doesn't, it doesn't have it. Any questions so far? So as we said, the background page is the main method of your code or your algorithm or whatever. So we look at it now. Yes? Yes, we can store it, we have to store it. So this will be in the background page.
Yeah, the background has the main method or the main?
Yeah, it doesn't have the word name, but it has your all your code there. And Chrome knows that this is the main page because it told it under the label background page in the manifest. If you look at the manifest here, you told the ground page is this one, specifically, actually there.
What about the other thing?
It will be handled, let's look at the content, the background, and then we can ask. It will be clear, it should be clear hopefully after we look at the background page. So we have here a function. This function executes the email operation. It takes the subject, the body, the selection, and tab ID because it replaces the tab contents, and it creates the email. We don't know how this function will be called yet, but let's look at it quickly. It gets some data. Default handler, is it the options? Is it Gmail or the other thing? If it's Gmail, we put here action URL. All these details, this code, I'll not go through it. Totally useless to explain it. Here, listen to this. Add listener. On connect. So this is the content script connecting to me, maybe the extension. It's sending me a message. So whenever the content script contacts me and sends a message, add this listener, which does what eventually? Does some validation and calls execute mail, basically. So the content script is there. If you click selection and do this, it's there. And when the message appears, this is how the email gets created. It calls the method that creates the email, change the URL, and does all the email details. Another listener here is onClicked, which means this click is for the extension itself. the first listener said, when the context script talks to you, do the business. But we didn't say that you should run the context script when you click on this. So this is here. Whenever you click, you should run the context script. You can see now that the code becoming real complex. If else, and error handling and different options. So this is a real problem, as opposed to the trivial thing that makes itself. And that's it, basically. All those details are about this is like handle the options, and this is the execute mail, and how to really make your browser send the email, and this is the setup for the two listeners that we want. Listener to the click on the extension icon, and listener to the message from the content script. So this is the basics. I don't think really I can explain the code because it's all if else's and. So hopefully, first that you know what's a Chrome extension in general, and you can navigate around an existing extension, see what's the code there, and you can make yourself a trivial Chrome extension. That would be the best outcome of today. Later, you can learn more about all the different APIs. As I mentioned, there are like 40 calls or more, and so many permissions, and so many details, and so many functions that you can add regarding to your design. Do we have any questions? Okay, thank you very much for your attention. I'll be on the demo pods in the afternoon today. If anyone tries these examples and they're not working, I can work with you or any other examples. And if you have any questions, not necessarily coding, or any questions regarding Google in general, please find me. I'll be on the demo pod in the afternoon. Thank you very much. Thank you.